Hello everyone. I would like to start off this video by saying thank you for taking the time out of your day or night to go ahead and watch my shitty content. I have noticed that a lot of people who watch the channel are not actually subscribed, so if you could please subscribe and would like to see more videos like this, please let me know down in the comments below and tell me other topics you would like to see cover. Now, without any further ado, let's begin. When people think of the term deadliest disease, they will often refer to a disease such as AIDS or malaria. Diseases that have claimed millions, if not billions. Some speculate half of all deaths in the world have contributed to malaria-related infections. And some believe that tuberculosis has killed over 3 billion in total. While all this may be true, there is a very particular disease that is very popular in certain cultures, such as movies. The disease that inspired zombies and vampires as far back as 1000 BC. Jeanna, Giese, a medical miracle. She should not be alive today. One typical normal day, one act of kindness led to the worst nightmare imaginable. One single encounter sealed her fate to a slow and agonizing death. A normal day at the church in Fond du Lac, Wisconsin. She walked into the church with her parents, Mr. and Mrs. Giese. At the church, there was a small flying creature that she claims to be a bat. People were swinging at the bat with their hats, trying to get it out of there. She tried to grab the bat by letting it onto her finger. She was walking out the door, and she suddenly felt a sharp stabbing pain in her right finger. The bat had bit her on the finger. The family thought nothing of it and decided to wash it off when they got home. This mistake should have cost her her life. She faced the deadliest virus known to man. Its name is rabies. Rabies is an uncommon infectious disease that attacks the brain and spinal cord. It is spread through all types of bodily fluids such as blood and saliva and even through your nails. Most people who get the disease are competent and oblivious enough to get inoculated as soon as possible. Some people aren't as lucky as they don't have access to the drug or are simply unaware of the consequences of not getting inoculated. The disease starts off fairly mild, typically with a tickling or a tingling sensation, sometimes a light burn type of feeling at the site or within a few centimeters of it. This is neuropathy caused from the virus traveling through the nerves. Once it reaches the spinal cord and then the brain, the clinical signs show. People think that rabies causes aggression by the disease controlling the brain. That is untrue. Rabies causes encephalitis. For those of you who don't know what encephalitis is, it is inflammation of the brain. This creates a sensory overload, kind of like what happens when an autistic child is overloaded by sensory input. Most animals' offensive instinct is to bite or scratch. Humans punch and kick instead, as they are more intelligent and are more adept at fighting standards. This is why you don't see human-to-human transmission of the virus. The combination of paralysis with the salivary glands and the encephalitis is what leads animals to transmit the disease. Effectively, it is perfectly engineered. After the first signs of aggression show, overall paralysis may occur, as well as psychosis, delusions, and hallucinations. In most cases, due to paralysis of the throat, when you drink water or any type of fluid, it will cause your throat to painfully spasm in such a way that you might throw up. Most people slip into a coma 10 days after clinical symptoms show and died of cardiorespiratory arrest. The disease is 100% fatal after symptoms show, unless a miracle occurs. A miracle that happened that day is the subject of the video. After displaying double vision and problems with basic coordinations, Gianna Giese's parents waited anxiously for test results to come back. All the tests they were doing was coming back negative, so her parents didn't think it was anything serious at the time. One time, she was playing volleyball, and her double vision made her think that two balls were headed towards her. She got hit by one of the balls trying to hit the wrong one. Her parents knew something was off. Gianna Giese's mother, Anne, decided it would be necessary to disclose that she was bitten by a bat. To the doctor's horror, he realized what was wrong. He asked how long ago this incident was.
Something made me tell him, you know, she was bit by a bat. His face turned white. I'm not kidding. He looked, well, when did that happen? About a month ago. Well, you know, and he made me tell him the whole how it happened and all that. And went over things again, her symptoms, and he says, I'll be right back.
She responded a month ago. Dr. Rodney Willoughby went into a frenzy. He knew that the girl was going to die. She was transferred to the intensive care unit in the Milwaukee Children's Hospital. Dr. Rodney Willoughby searched desperately for some kind of treatment or cure. Knowing full well that she was going to die, he decided to try a new experimental procedure that he created. He called it the Milwaukee Protocol. The page has been updated several times, the most recent being back in November of 2018. The steps of the protocol, which I have been simplified for you, are as follows. 1. Do not administer the rabies vaccine after clinical symptoms. This will delay the creation of antibodies, and the whole premise of this protocol is for the patient to create rabies antibodies to fight the disease. 2. Keep the patient in isolation. There have never been any human-to-human infections of rabies besides through organ donation. Nonetheless, you must keep the patient in isolation. 3. Transfer patients with laboratory-confirmed rabies to a tertiary care facility capable of critical care, including intracranial pressure monitoring. Institutions in developing countries can handle rabies if they treat head trauma or tetanus within critical care units. 4. Treatment requires access to a rabies reference lab. Transport needs to be prioritized. There can be delays in transporting samples to rabies referencing laboratories and in their analysis, and reporting that to compromise patient care. Reporting should be done by telephone or email as quickly as possible, in addition to through standard reporting channels. Depending on logistics of transport, treatment with the Milwaukee Protocol may need to begin. If the patient is approaching day 5 without a diagnosis. Sedation for 7 days is less dangerous than untreated rabies. 5. Treatment also requires access to a rehabilitation facility. Rabies rewires the brain and makes it work in a dysfunctional way, causing dysautonomia, which causes the autonomic nervous system to work differently. The autonomic nervous system is, as the name suggests, the automatic functioning of keeping your body alive. The scrambled signals is what causes the brain to shut down the body. If the patient survives, they will require therapy to rewire the brain. Count hospital days. Starting from HD0 from the first day of admission to inpatient care, this is more accurate than the counting days of prodromal symptoms for predicting complications. 7. Some patients may experience delays in seeking hospitalization. We generally count hospital days in the patient from day of objective neurological signs. Example, severe agitation, paralysis, movement disorder, tachyarrhythmias, bradycardia, and priapism that would normally lead to hospitalization. For those of you who don't know some of these terms, tachyarrhythmia is an irregular heartbeat in which it beats faster than 100 beats per minute when you are doing nothing that should be increasing it, and bradycardia is the exact opposite, meaning a slow heartbeat. These are both very dangerous and require immediate hospitalization. Priapism is a spontaneous erectile response with no source of arousal. Not to be confused with just a random erection during the day, this is much, much worse. 8. Aggressive sedation is essential in the first week of hospitalization. Minimize stimulation. Do not perform intraoral neurological exams. Increase sedation until there are no autonomic responses to the stimuli associated with medical care. We do not care about abnormal movements. Not care about normal movements. Seizures are very rare in uncomplicated rabies. Example, arrest. And should focus on and should suggest an alternative diagnosis. There is always some tachycardia and fluctuation in rabies. We must tolerate some. By significant dysautonomia that we treat with sedation, we refer to heart rates and blood pressures above or below the 99th percentile for the age and height. 9. Reduce sedation aggressively starting with HD8 or day 8. Attempt to wean every 12 hours. Sedation should be held off by HD12 if possible. The vagus nerve is no longer functional at this point. Atropine ceases to be effective. Tolerate abnormal movements, particularly of the face. These are not seizures, are common during recovery, and do not respond to usual sedatives. Consider addition of ketamine when additional sedation is needed. Do not aggressively tapper if there is a cerebral edema. The drugs I listed above are sedatives. And to put it short for you, a cerebral edema is a buildup of fluid in the brain, or aka hydrocephalus. 10. Place a central venous catheter, urinary catheter, and NG tube. An NG tube is recommended for nutrition during the 5 brief period of ileus encountered in rabies in the second week. Rabies virus incapacitates the myenteric plexus in the gut. 10. For those of you who don't know, I skipped like 20 steps just now. This is like step 30, but if you want to read the whole complex thing for yourself, please click the link in the description below. Administer a lot of drugs that will ease the symptoms of rabies. After a diagnosis is clear and monitoring is in check, put them in a very deep medically induced coma, wait patiently for the patient to develop antibodies for the disease, and wait until the patient is clear. Jeanna Giese, after surviving rabies, became a media sensation in 2004. After leaving the hospital after almost 2 months, she survived the fight for her life, but she had to pay a horrible debt. She spent over 2 years recovering as if she had reset, kind of. It was like raising a baby from scratch. The good news of it all is that the Milwaukee Protocol has become a new and more effective treatment known as the Recife Protocol, and we are nearing 20 official survivors of rabies. This is a huge step in the fight against the deadliest disease known to man. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you have not, well, I'm sorry. And if Jeanna Giese is watching this video, I am very proud that you fought for your life, and I'm proud that you survived. If Dr. Willoughby is somehow watching this, you're a genius. That's all I'm gonna say, you're a fucking genius. Anyways, I hope you guys had fun watching this video. If you guys want to see more medical videos or science videos in general, please let me know down in the comments below, and be specific on what topics you want me to cover, and I'll see you guys next time.